Hey there guys, RadioFace here, back for another episode of Stardew Valley. This is episode 114, Tuesday, the 2nd of spring. And it's a sunny day, I believe. No events going on today that I'm aware of. But I've got a lot of work to do around the farm. A lot. The beginning of this season, I'm just going to kind of be a hermit tending to my farm. Okay, no events. Welcome to Kozu 5, your number one source for weather, news, and entertainment. And now, the weather forecast for tomorrow. It's going to rain all day tomorrow. Doesn't really affect me. Ooh, I see a glimmer within my scrying orb, a shard of knowledge from the future. The spirits are very happy today. They will do their best to shower everyone with good fortune. Nice. What did they want? Largemouth bass. Actually, conveniently enough, I have one. What time is that at? 7 p.m. Okay. We'll go do that today at 7 p.m. Check the mail. Dear RadioFace, I am now selling higher quality fertilizers as well as new crop selections. See you soon. Oh, what? Today you're selling new crops? Are you serious, Pierre? Good morning, Maxwell. Hello, Bumby. I'm gonna be a little miffed if you're selling new crops today, but not yesterday when I spent all of my money pretty much. I mean, I could have saved some more of my money, I guess, but still. Ah, good morning, Gretch. Go ahead and let you out. Check on the chickens. Ooh, two of you were hungry. Please. Good morning. Let me go ahead and let you guys out. Run over all of my crops, completely trample them. Yeah, we're gonna let a lot of these trees propagate. That way we have them. And I mean, if I accidentally take out a few, it's not that big of a deal. Whoops. Came by and dropped all of this wood. Oh, I almost forgot where I left you, Bumby. Let's go see if I have good reason to be upset with Pierre or not today. Let's also get some of the local forage. Nice. Ah, what a beautiful day. Ooh, what's on the board? Eat a sunfish. I can try, but I make no guarantees. Okay, you've changed nothing. Good. Better keep it that way, Pierre. Back to the farm. I've got lots of work to do. A lot of work to do. So much work. And all by 7 p.m. too. Alright, Bumby, I'll leave you over here. me just run around and take care of all of these instead of constantly swapping tools. Whoops. Darn. I was hoping I could do it without destroying that little tree, but okay. Ooh, I did not see you earlier. Resources on my farm. There we go. Take care of you and you. Piece of coal, a little bit random. Okay, that actually takes care of it all. Nice. With plenty of time to spare too. Boom. You off. And you. Yeah, that's a little spooky how that went. You guys go into like forage. I don't know what was there, but it was in my way. I should have plenty of what I need. Oh man. So all I had was enough to make one scarecrow? Eek. Okay, well, it's for the sake of completeness. I want this area well protected. None of you have encountered any crows, have you? Okay. Hey, that's good for me. Means crows are not much of a problem right now. Put you away. Okay, Bumby, let's go explore a little bit while we can. I am going to put down some grass starter in some of these more barren areas, to be honest. There we go. Like here? Yeah, that can definitely use some grass starter. As can right there. Up over here. Not really any down there. I can put a little bit there. A little bit here. I'm gonna put some over here, say. Yeah. Just to encourage it to grow. Even put some up here. And some over for Maxwell. And a little bit down there. I think that'll be nice. Whoops. That's a bit of a silly place to put it. Honestly, I don't even think you should be able to grow there. It's a little weird. Okay. So, about to be 7. Really ought to head over to Jody's. I don't want to be late. We have the largemouth bass at the ready. Yeah, that way we can have dinner. That sounds nice. That was really nice of them to invite me. Hello, Jody. Am I going to get to your house before you? Let's see. I did. Hey, Clint. Or Kent, my bad. Sorry. Hi, RadioFace. Please come in. Thank you. Sorry about getting your name wrong. Ah, I'm so glad you came, RadioFace, and you brought the fish. Wonderful. Of course. Sam, could you come in here and help clean this fish? Yes, ma'am. The face he made. I'll just put it on the floor for you. Wow, it looks wonderful and it smells so fresh. Thanks so much for doing this, RadioFace. I think it was Linus who gave this to me, so you should thank him. Kent caught a fish too, but he eats about a whole fish to himself. I feel you. I have a large appetite as well. Mmm, that crispy bass was delicious. The breading was to die for. I almost feel like a part of the family now. That was really nice of them. Wow, that took no time at all? Huh. Yeah, Kent does not like me. We are not friends. Oh. Need some help there? You should get a ladder. Hello. Oh, RadioFace, you scared me. My bad. I tend to be pretty sneaky. See that fruit up there? It looks delicious, doesn't it? I can't reach it. I wonder what it is. I didn't even ask? Thanks. I should have at least asked first, or offered rather. Okay, got it. You're stronger than you look. Thank you. Here, try a piece. Sure. Wow. It looks different than what you harvested. And it looks like I ate the whole thing. 2 mice. You know, I just realized something. Even if my art career is a flop, I always have a friend to catch me on the way down. Of course. Besides, no guarantee it'll be a flop. The only guarantee you'll fail is if you don't even bother trying first. Horseradish. Yes, please. Ooh, I wonder if the spring onions are growing. Let us go to the onion patch. Hello there. Nope. Sorry, Bumby. Me and these spring onions have business to attend to. And that is it. Okay. Oop. What are you doing? This is such an odd spot for you. Game is behaving very oddly today. Wonder why that is. No matter. Be a good time to go to bed. Nice and early today. Let's get out of here. Need to close your guys' doors. There you go. Make sure Gretch is in. Yep. Awesome. I don't really know if there's a recipe involving those, but I'll hang on to the gold ones. Alright, Bumby. See you later. You have a good night. Good night to you too, Maxwell. Good night, everybody. Ooh. Good bit of money. Onions were worth practically nothing. Rainy day. Alright, well, that is it for me, RadioFace. That was Stardew Valley episode 114, Tuesday, the 2nd of spring. Let me know what you think of the content in the comment section below. If you like it, please leave a like. Please consider subscribing. Every little bit always helps. I hope that you have a good day, that you've had a good day, and that this helped make your day a little bit better. Bye-bye now.